so we'd have a good life. Raised us with love so we could fly. Anyone else would call you Superman, but I just call you Dad. So I want to thank you, give you a pat on the back for doing what you did, no questions asked. I could never say enough. Through the downs and the ups, you carried the weight so we'd have a good life. Raised us with love so we could fly.
Congregation, please be seated. On behalf of Brian's family, I'd like to welcome everyone to this funeral service. Your presence here is deeply appreciated. Getting together to honor the memory of someone that you love and to have friends and neighbors join together in support is a precious thing. Let's begin this service with a prayer. Almighty God, you're the source of mercy and the giver of comfort. Today, we remember Brien. Thank you for giving him to us, to know and love as a companion in our journey here on earth. In your endless compassion, comfort us who mourn. Give us your help and give us eyes to see in death the gate to eternal life. Help us to always be mindful of the shortness and uncertainty of human life so that we may seek more than anything to know you, Lord God, to love you, and to faithfully live out your purposes for our lives. Please give us a sure and certain faith in you, and comfort us with a sure confidence that we will one day be reunited with those who have died in faith. And we pray this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. I'd like to ask Trevor and Wendy to come forward with the eulogy.
Brien Douglas Ward was born on September 3rd, 1948, to Doug and Margaret Ward. Dad was born and raised in the Telebe Lake area alongside his brothers, Leo and Warren. Their childhood was filled with riding horses, playing numerous sports, and helping Papa on the farm. It is here Dad learned his strong work ethic from his dad. The job should always get done with no complaining. Dad and Leo got into quite a bit of mischief together on the farm. It was also on the farm that Dad learned horses weren't for him. After multiple broken bones and missing teeth, he thought he was a better fit for running machinery. Dad was also known to be a natural athlete, and more specifically, a strong hockey player and an incredible pitcher. He spent many weekends in the summer with the Telebe Lake Blues, traveling from town to town, competing in tournaments. And from what we hear, they were very successful. We have been told that he had opportunities to continue with both hockey and ball, but he chose to stay at home and look after his young family. Mom and Dad met at a New Year's Eve dance. Wendy remembers Mom telling her that Dad told her, "You may not have been her first kiss, but it would be her last." And sure enough, he was right. Mom and Dad eloped April 11th, 1970. This was very much like Dad. He never needed much of a commotion. Mom and Dad enjoyed 31 years of fishing, camping, raising their family, and working in the yard, even though it was more Mom's project. Dad would do whatever Mom wanted, whether it was a root cellar or planting trees. Dad would get it done. Dad and Mom enjoyed the community. They helped out when it was needed and always enjoyed the dances, curling bonspiels, and skidoo rallies. It was a huge part of their lives. Camping was also something the two of them enjoyed. They spent many weekends in the summer at different lakes. Dad had a boat that he spent hour after hour pulling kids and teaching us how to ski. As parents, now we look back in awe of the patience he had. Dad and Mom were fortunate to have strong friendships in the community. They spent many nights up at Terry and Linda's playing cards, which sometimes ended in singing and dancing. And Dad watched many hockey games with Jeannie and Lindsay. Dad lost Mom in 2001, and we felt he lost the love of his life. But even with this heartbreak, he kept living his life, and he wanted us to do the same. Dad had a love for sports and hunting. He enjoyed watching hockey and baseball. Wendy and her family took him to a couple Blue Jays games, one in Toronto and one in New York. He enjoyed them both, but when he got home, it made him appreciate that he lived in Telebi Lake. He couldn't get over the amount of people in Times Square. Dad loved hunting, but his favorite was goose hunting. It was the action he enjoyed, along with spending time with his grandkids, Terry, Shane, and many others.
Grandpa was a family man. He was blessed with 7 grandchildren that he was so proud of. He loved attending their activities and accomplishments, from dance, hockey, curling, basketball, soccer, ball, to graduations and weddings. His grandchildren were such a huge part of his life, and I know that they would say Grandpa was a huge influence in theirs as well. Here are some of the grandkids' favorite memories of him. Darby loved spending summers working at Frog Lake with Grandpa. Hauling water, doing the sewers, and just spending time together were some of her favorite days. She also felt so fortunate that Grandpa Brien got to be Papa to Tayton for a few weeks. He would always call to ask, "How's that girl doing?" Darby will miss those calls so much, but thankful that she got to spend 28 years with the best man she knows. Dallas. A favorite memory of Grandpa is sitting in blinds or cornfields hunting geese, driving around early in the morning looking for deer, and he would let me eat Cheesies and Dr. Pepper for breakfast. Seeing him in the stands at his games and shaking his hand after was another special memory for him. One of Dawson's favorite memories with Grandpa was watching him fillet fish while she was right next to him, taking the eyes out of a previous catch. She also was always up for a day trip to Cold Lake, where there was usually a stop at a dollar store, and somehow she got Grandpa to spend a whopping $70. There wasn't a single time Darren and her cousins would miss out on a hello hug or a goodbye hug from their grandpa. She never passed up on the opportunity to brag about how she got her middle name from her favorite guy. Her favorite memory with Grandpa was walking up to Grandpa's camper at Frog Lake, either for breakfast or to ask if he had any Mr. Noodles for her. And Grandpa, being Grandpa, made sure he always stocked up so he never had to say no. It is easy to realize how lucky all of us are to have had something that hurts this much to lose. Alandra. Alandra admits she may not have been the best shot, but some of her favorite memories came when Grandpa would show her how to wring the necks and field dress the geese, and she is still in awe of how easy it was for him. She is so grateful she was able to learn what she did from Grandpa and was deeply influenced by his kind heart and strong hands. Caius. Caius enjoyed winter snow rides when Grandpa would pull him, his siblings, and his cousins in the calf sled behind the side-by-side. In more recent years, Caius was sharing Grandpa's passion for goose hunting and eagerly looked forward to the fall hunt while learning from Grandpa about the guns and which one to use for what purpose. Coyotes beware. Dax has fond memories of sneaking sugar cubes from the box on Grandpa's table while everyone else was having coffee. Grandpa always seemed to have the open box pointing in Dax's direction. He was also blessed to become a papa to his great-granddaughter, Tayton, and was fortunate to meet her. He told me she was such a cute little jigger, and he looked forward to his visits with her. Dad enjoyed work, and he liked to be busy. He began his work years when he was quite young at Telstar, building roads. He would often talk about the roads that he helped build. He then decided to venture out on his own with Bry Ward Trenching, and this company was successful. Then he worked for ATCO Gas up until he retired. This retirement worried Dad, as he liked to be busy. But he soon realized that he would be kept almost busier helping his kids, grandkids, family with harvest, and numerous neighbors. Dad was a great neighbor, always willing to help. It didn't matter the task, he would always say, "I'll be right there." Elaine in particular appreciated Dad being there after Leo passed. Shane remembers, no matter the job, he would always respond with, "Oh no, we'll get it done, no worries." Dad also kept busy with Warren, cutting and selling wood. I think they both enjoyed this, as it was something that reminded them of Papa. If you know Dad and Warren, you know they're a little competitive and stubborn. So when one went out to cut wood, the other one wasn't far behind. Warren said it was always a race to get to the wood pile before Dad. There aren't enough words or paragraphs to talk about the wonderful person Dad was. From his generosity, he would share anything he had with anyone. His kindness, didn't matter who you were, he did not judge people, he was kind to everyone. His friendliness, always having time to say hello, have a coffee, or a daily morning phone call with a friend. His sense of humor, he always enjoyed a good laugh. There are so many memories and stories we could tell today, but Dad wanted this to be quick. So when we leave today, we hope you keep sharing these memories. We also joke that the only things happy about Dad's passing are coyotes, gophers, and squirrels.
Thank you, Trevor and Wendy. Well, when I think of Brien, I think of the very short period of time, and I stress that word very short, that I was actually a member of the Tullaby Lake Blues fastball team. And it was a very short time. I don't know if I might have played a couple tournaments, maybe. But I'm sure most of you here know that Brien could chuck a ball. I'm glad I played on his team. I'm sure to the batters on the opposing teams, he looked like he was 10 feet tall with a 6-foot-long arm. And could he ever chuck it? Whoa. When he wound up with that windmill pitch, that ball was coming, and it was coming fast. Many of you knew Brien a lot better than I did, and his family, of course, even more so. You knew Brien as a father, a grandfather, a brother-in-law. He was a father-in-law, an uncle, and Tayton, Brian's great-granddaughter, even got to see him. Now, she may not remember seeing him, but she'll know him by the stories that you tell her and the pictures that she sees. Many people in this community, and also those whom Brien got to know through his work, considered him a friend and a role model. He was someone that they were glad to have known. More than one has said, told me, "I'm going to miss him." The family walked in today to a song called "Dad" by Tyler Wood. And I think that's a great song that you guys picked. Because I think, to a large extent, the lyrics of that song describe Brien. I'm going to read some of the words because chances are we weren't all paying attention to the words as the family was coming in. An early riser, always on timer. A backbreaker, giver, not a taker. Made sure nothing was missing. A patient teacher, strong, steady leader. Firm handshaker, never met a stranger. Tough as steel, heart of gold. You did what you did, no questions asked. A spirit lifter, problem fixer. Words of reason, there when you need them. Calm you down, set you straight. I appreciate all the little life lessons. You carried the weight so we'd have a good life. Raised us with love so we could fly. Anyone else would have called you Superman, but I call you Dad. I watched the official video to that song on YouTube. At the end, there's a quote from the Bible. The quote goes like this: I have no greater joy than to hear that my children are walking in the truth. And that's taken from 3 John verse 4. On the surface, we can interpret that verse to mean that a father and a grandfather is really happy when he hears that his children and grandchildren are carrying on and continuing to live according to the things that he's taught them, following his example. You've probably heard of Peter, James, and John. They were the top three of Jesus' disciples. The quote at the end of Tyler Wood's song video was written by John. When he talks about my children, in quotes, he's probably talking about those to whom that he's passed on his knowledge of Jesus. As the result of his preaching, John was the spiritual father of many. For John, walking in the truth means living in a way that honors and pleases God. It could mean living in Christ, since Jesus himself said, I am the truth. So if you're walking in the truth, you're walking in Christ. John was old when he wrote that letter. He wanted his readers to know that he had no greater joy than to hear that those whom he had taught were following Jesus. And I don't think Brien liked funerals. For that matter, I don't think anybody likes funerals. Brien's family tells me that he would have wanted this service to be short. Now, Trevor and Wendy, I'm just going to ask you a question. First, it's going to be towards you, but it's not specifically to you. It's really for everybody. Do you think that when you were growing up, your dad sometimes knew more about what you were up to than he let on? Now, I don't want to draw too much attention to Trevor and Wendy, because we all do things that disappoint our parents. Just like we all do things that disappoint our Heavenly Father. But our earthly parents don't stop loving us when we do something wrong. And even more so, our Heavenly Father. He doesn't stop loving us if we do something wrong. John 3:16 says, God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. I call that love. The loss of Brien is a biggie. None of us knew that he'd be taken from us so suddenly, but God did. But that doesn't mean that God doesn't love Brien, and it doesn't mean that God doesn't love each one of us. Jesus said, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. The Lord draws near to the brokenhearted. Jesus also said, I'm the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. That's a promise. Eternal life with Jesus. Romans 10:13 says, everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. I like that word, everyone. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord. The Bible tells us that you can know without a doubt that God will give eternal salvation to all who believe that Jesus Christ, his only Son, died on a Roman cross and rose again. Now, you won't forget Brian. You're going to keep on loving him. You're going to miss him. He was taken so suddenly that there are probably things you didn't get a chance to tell him. Didn't get a chance to say to him. Well, you can tell God because he's a good listener. 1 Peter 5, 7 says, cast all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. Now, for us who are gathered here, Brien was someone that we learned from. Someone that we want to be like. He was an example to follow. A father wants his children to do well, to succeed, to be happy. You are the heirs of Brien's legacy. Keep telling those Brien stories. And remember, too, that your Heavenly Father has promised a place in heaven for all those who believe. Let's pray. God of grace, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to give us life that never ends. We are so thankful that because of his death, Jesus destroyed the power of death. And by his resurrection, he made it possible for all who believe in him to live with him forever in his kingdom. Make us certain that because he lives, we will live also, and that nothing will be able to separate us from his love. Neither death nor life, neither the present nor the future, nor anything else. Hear our prayer for the sake of Jesus, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, there is going to be a video presentation.
Was a promise really something people just something they would say. And then forget families really bow their heads to pray. The daddies really never go away. Whoa, whoa, grandpa, tell me about them good old days. Whoa, whoa, grandpa, tell me about them good old days.
I can make a living from walking in the woods. You can bet I'd be sitting pretty good, high on a hill, looking at a field downwind. If I can make a nickel off of turning in bass, never worry about the price of gas. I'd be wheeling and dealing and sitting there reeling them in. Hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning, late in the evening, I'm getting red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting, fishing and loving every day. Baby wants to roll with me, throws her boots on, climbs in a tree, tucking her hair in my hat, and she's ready to go. And we get to hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning, late in the evening, getting red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. So while y'all are up there breathing in that old dirty air, I'll be down here knee deep.
Ren, what do you have? How many did you shoot?
Hunting and fishing, loving every day. I want to see them tall pines sway. Y'all close them eyes, let's go there in our mind. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. That's the prayer this country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Black coffee in the morning, dark whiskey in the evening. I get red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting and fishing and loving every day.
Too small, though.
Just a baby, that's okay.
Won't you come along with me? Won't you come along with me? I know you want to see. I'm hunting and fishing and loving every day. Yeah.
An early riser, always on timer. A backbreaker, giver, not a taker. Made sure nothing was missing, so we could have everything you didn't. A patient teacher, strong, steady leader. Firm handshaker, never met a stranger. Tough as steel, hard to go. It took a while, but now I know all the little life lessons, but you never expected. A thank you, a pat on the back. You did what you did, no questions asked. I could never say enough. Through the downs and the ups, you carried the weight so we'd have a good life. Raised us with love so we could fly. Anyone else would call you Superman, but I just call you Dad.
Did you
yes.
get one?
No.
Okay.
Yep. And the right size too.
What
you
is
know,
it?
I
has it work?
Had one that the big auger.
It's for taking the ice out of the hole, I think. Right?
You betcha.
Slides down.
Problem fixer, words of reason. There when you need them, calm you down, set you straight. Yeah, I appreciate all the little life lessons, but you never expected. A thank you, a pat on the back. You did what you did, no questions asked. I could never say enough. Through the downs and the ups, you carried the weight so we'd have a good life. Raised us with love so we could fly. Call you Superman, but I just call you Dad. I just call you when I'm lost, when I'm empty, when I need a little help. Whenever I get good news, you're the first one I want to tell. So I want give you a pat on the back for doing what you did, no questions asked. I could never say enough. Through the downs and the ups, you carried the weight so we'd have a good life. Raised us with love so we could fly. Anyone else would call you Superman. I call you Dad.
Wish every porch had a swing. Wish kids still learned to say sir and ma'am, how to shake a hand. I wish every state had a Birmingham. I wish everybody knew all the words to mama tried. Wish Monday mornings felt just like Friday nights. And I wish even cars had truck beds. And every road was named Copperhead. And coolers never run out of cold Bud Light. And I wish high school home teams never lost. And back road drinking kids never got caught. And I wish the price of gas was low. And cotton was high. I wish honky tonks didn't have no closing time. And I wish grandpas never died. I wish Sundays on a creek bank would never end. Wish I could learn to drive again.
raised the first time 17. She was my everything. Kiss in a Chevrolet could happen every day. I wish everybody overseas was gonna make it home. I wish country music still got played on country radio. And I wish even cars had truck beds and every road was named.
Getting big.
I need something to help.
You need help?
Can you hold it down?
Yeah.
I wish high school home teams never lost. Back row drinking kids never got caught. I wish the price of gas was low and cotton was high. I wish honky tonks didn't have no closing time. And I wish grandpa's never died. Never died.
Let us commend Brien to Almighty God. Jesus, our merciful Savior, we commit Brien to your care. Receive him into your loving arms, into the peace that never ends, into the fellowship of all your people who now live in your marvelous light. Amen. Receive the benediction. May Jesus grant to us all that we might follow in faith where he has led the way. May the Holy Spirit, the true source of all comfort, draw us near to him in our sorrow. When we feel darkness descending on us, may we can remember that Jesus is the light of the world. In him there is no darkness at all. And now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This concludes the ceremony here.
I read a note my grandma wrote back in 1923. Grandpa kept it in his coat, and he showed it once to me. He said, "Boy, you might not understand, but a long, long time ago, Grandma's daddy didn't like me none, but I loved your grandma so. We had this crazy plan to meet and run away together, get married in the first town we came to and live forever. But nailed to the tree where we were supposed to meet instead, I found this letter, and this is what it said. If you get there before I do, don't give up on me.